Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about absorption and assimilation. Starting with absorption. Absorption is the process whereby digested food substances are absorbed into the body cells. The products of digestion, such as simple sugars, amino acids, fatty acids, and glycerol, are absorbed throughout the small intestines and transported to the bloodstream. Water and mineral salts are also absorbed by small intestine and colon. Do note that the hepatic portal vein transports blood-rich and absorbed nutrients from the small intestine to the liver. Let's look at the adaptation of small intestine for absorption. The small intestine is very long and folded. And this increases the surface area to volume ratio for absorption to take place rapidly. There is the presence of villi and microvilli. And these protrusion in the intestinal wall further increase the surface area. The villi have one cell thick epithelium, allowing the diffusion of digested food substances to occur rapidly into the blood capillaries. The intestinal wall and villi are richly supplied with blood vessels so as to transport sugars and amino acids away from the small intestine. As food substances are transported away, a concentration gradient is maintained to facilitate diffusion. The villi contain lacteals, which transport fats away from the small intestine. Similarly, a concentration gradient is maintained to facilitate diffusion. The smooth muscles that constantly relax and contract in a wave-like pattern, which we know is peristalsis, allows food to be brought into close contact with the intestinal walls. At the capillaries, there is absorption of water-soluble nutrients such as glucose, amino acids, mineral salts, vitamin B, vitamin C, and water. The simple sugar and amino acids diffuse through the walls of the villi into the blood capillaries. These capillaries converge into the hepatic portal vein, which then brings these nutrients to the liver. At the lacteal, there is absorption of fat-soluble nutrients such as glycerol, fatty acids, vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. Fatty acids and glycerol enter epithelium of villus, forming fat globules that enter lacteals. Now let's look at assimilation. Assimilation is the process where absorbed nutrients are converted into new protoplasm or used to provide energy. Sugar is oxidized for energy. And excess sugars are converted into glycogen, which is stored in liver and muscles. Amino acids are used for growth of new cells and repair damaged cells. And excess amino acids are deaminated to form urea. Fats can be oxidized for energy. And excess fats are stored in adipose tissues. The functions of liver are as follow. First, carbohydrate metabolism. Normal blood glucose level is from 70 to 90 milligrams per 100 milliliters of blood. When blood glucose level is too high, excess glucose is converted to glycogen by insulin. When blood glucose level is too low, glycogen is converted to glucose by glucagon. Excess amino acids undergo deamination to form urea for excretion. The liver also has detoxification functions. It produces enzymes that convert toxic substances such as metabolic waste, drugs, alcohol, and chemicals into substances that can be excreted. To end this video, we will look at the harmful effects of excessive consumption of alcohol. The immediate and short-term effects are lowered inhibition, loss of coordination, loss of critical judgment, vision impairment, increased reaction time, vomiting, and passing out. The long-term harmful effects are liver cirrhosis, liver cancer, stomach ulcers and gastric pains, cardiomyopathy, and impaired development of brain for those who consume before the age of 18. That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.